Gun police are hunting down a potentially dangerous suspect. They say he led them on a chase, caused a fiery crash, and left his girlfriend and two children trapped in the burning wreckage yesterday. Greg Barnes shows us how bystanders helped to save the children.
It is a picture burned into Marie Cunningham's mind, and she had but one thought.
Someone had to get the kids out of the car, get them away because it was on fire.
Cunningham and two other bystanders in Dunn rescued two young boys and their mother from this burning wreckage just seconds before it exploded yesterday. What no one could believe was what the driver did.
As soon as we got here, he went out, he crawled through the back seat, crawled over the kids, and went out the back door, and then he took off running.
Dunn police say this guy, 23-year-old Henry Mitchell, was doing close to 100 miles an hour when he swerved off the road, clipped a sign, smashed through a fence, and then hit five cars.
I've been an officer here for 11 years, and this by far is the worst accident I've had to investigate.
Today, more than 24 hours later, you can still see the debris and even smell the gasoline and the oil from where this wreck happened. The incident actually started, police say, further down Carolina Avenue here towards I-95, where a police officer had tried to stop Mitchell for suspected speeding. Police say the two boys, ages 3 and 6, and their mother were banged up and cut, but will be okay. 24-year-old Danielle Cordo is now charged with two counts of child abuse and jailed under $3,000 bond. Her children are in foster care. Dunn police say Henry Mitchell is wanted in Florida for assaulting a police officer there. They suspect he ran to a nearby truck stop after the crash and hitched a ride. Marie Cunningham says she's no hero.
It's just something I thought anybody would do when there's children and people trapped in it. They need help.
In Dunn, Greg Barnes, ABC 11, Eyewitness News at 10.